Most people think the A-10 Warthog is all about its gun. But what's really impressive about it goes beyond the gun and even beyond the aircraft itself. It's about the mission. Taking off, attacking targets, coming back, reloading, and doing that again and again and again. In fact, during some tests, one Warthog flew 17 missions in one day. And these back-to-back missions were practiced for one reason. The A-10 is the first aircraft in the US Air Force history designed and built for the sole purpose of supporting the Army's combat soldier, a role commonly referred to as CAS, or close air support. A good CAS aircraft needs to have four attributes. Maneuverability, so it can hit its targets while avoiding counterfire. Survivability, in case it gets hit from small arms or surface-to-air missiles. Staying power, so it could loiter for long periods over the battlefield. And load carrying, so it could destroy more targets during each sortie. The A-10 Warthog had all of them. But why this aircraft kept its engines running in between missions? Why its Gatling gun doesn't eject casings like normal guns do? Why the A-10 pilots have to sit inside the bathtub during flight? And why the enemy forces were relieved whenever they heard the sound of the A-10's gun? Is not what you think. When the A-10 was first introduced, guided munitions were at their infancy. So to hit a target accurately, especially in a CAS mission, the A-10 had to fly low and slow to have the best chance of hitting its target, communist tanks. The A-10 came into the picture during the Europe of the 1970s, where communist nations outnumbered other nations' tanks with a 2-to-1 ratio. Lucky for the European allies, the A-10's GAU-8 Gatling gun was the biggest, most accurate weapon ever fired from an aircraft that could destroy a tank's armor in a single short burst. That sound not only was appreciated by the friendly forces, knowing that someone's got their back, but also by the enemy, because if they could hear the gun, it meant they were not the target. At least, not just yet. But the gun wasn't the only tank-killer weapon on the Warthog. The aircraft could also carry imaging infrared Maverick missiles, called IIR for short. The IIR was an air-to-surface missile that could literally see in the dark, making it ideal for night use or in marginal weather conditions. Instead of using visible light, the camera used the heat generated by the target to build a video feed that was displayed on a small screen inside the cockpit. This helped the pilot pinpoint the targets even in the dead of night and destroy them effectively, a strategy that worked well for the A-10 Warthog. And if you're also a fan of military strategy games, you should check out Conflict of Nations, the sponsor of this video. Conflict of Nations is a free online PvP strategy game where you can choose a real country and lead it through World War III. You can use anything from tanks and fighter jets to nuclear submarines to build your military and engage in battles against up to 128 other players. Your neighbors could be your enemy, or you could make alliances. The choice is yours. These are real-time, long-term strategy games that can take weeks to complete. This game is fully cross-platform, so you can play Conflict of Nations with the same account on both PC and mobile devices. And we bring you an exclusive gift. Click on the link in the description to get 13,000 gold and 1 month of premium subscription for free. This offer is only available for 30 days, so don't miss out. Equally as impressive as the weapon systems, was the rate at which the A-10 could fly missions back-to-back. During one test, the aircraft flew 17 times back-to-back in a single day. Yes, one aircraft, but 8 different pilots, which switched places in between missions. During those 17 simulated missions, the aircraft only accumulated 3 minor maintenance write-ups, none of which were serious enough to interfere with conducting further missions. The turnaround time on the ground was also mind-boggling. The average ground time was less than 11 minutes if only bombs had to be reloaded. When both fueling and arming was required, it took less than 20 minutes. To minimize ground time, the engines were left turning the whole time. This not only saved time, but also minimized potential engine problems that could have come up during the engine restart. Normally, the munition crew would wait for maintenance to be done and then take the aircraft to a bomb loading area. But in this case, there were two munition load crews assigned to each aircraft, and they did their work in the maintenance area while the maintenance crew were servicing the aircraft. These actions may seem insignificant, but shaving off as little as 15 minutes from that total turnaround time could have a real impact at the front lines. During combat, the A-10s would fly to the target, attack it several times, return to the field, rearm, and take off again. Now multiply that 15-minute time saving by the 17 sorties flown by a single A-10, and that adds up to 4 hours and 15 minutes saved by each aircraft per day, or 6 extra missions that could be flown. To the GIs on the ground, this can be the difference between life and death. Reloading the Gatling gun with 800 rounds took less than 16 minutes. Initially, this reloading process could only be done manually. That was until a specially designed machine, nicknamed the Dragon, was introduced, which could load and unload 1,350 rounds in under 10 minutes. You heard that right, load and unload, because the gun doesn't eject the casings as it fires the rounds. The primary reason for not ejecting the casings has nothing to do with reducing the risk of them being ingested into the engines or damaging the aircraft. It's because of their weight. The casings act as ballast for the center of gravity of the aircraft. If the empty shells were to be ejected, it could throw off the A-10's center of gravity. So instead, the casings from the fired rounds are cycled back into the gun's rotating drum and collected within the gun's housing. It's only when the A-10's gun is reloaded on the ground that the spent casings are offloaded, which is done simultaneously as the live rounds are being loaded in. The A-10 is a big aircraft with a wingspan of almost 59 feet. These large wings give it the ability to fly at low speeds and have great maneuverability, but also more room to hold up to 16,000 pounds of underwing bombs and rockets. The thing is, in getting up close to the enemy forces in order to engage with them, the pilot and the airplane are inevitably put in the range of enemy fire. So, as a survivability measure, the A-10 was designed to survive several hits that would bring down most other aircraft. Warthog could in fact fly with one engine, half of the tail, one elevator, and half of a wing missing. The fuel tanks were also self-sealing, meaning that if hit by bullets, fuel wouldn't leak. Another unique feature of the Warthog was the landing gear. After takeoff, the undercarriage would be retracted into the fuselage like most other airplanes, but part of the wheels would continue to protrude outside the belly. This was done by design. Once the mission was over, in case the landing gear couldn't be deployed due to damage or hydraulics failure, the A-10 would be forced to do a belly landing, also known as a gear-up landing. Having parts of the wheels outside meant that the airplane could still roll on its belly rather than skid, which would minimize the damage. Now that all sounds great, but it wouldn't bring the aircraft back if the pilot had been shot. Which brings us to the bathtub. The cockpit and parts of the flight control system in the A-10 Warthog are protected by 1,200 pounds of titanium aircraft armor, referred to as the bathtub, because it looks like one. This armor has been tested to withstand hits from 23mm cannon fire and high explosives. Without the bathtub, the A-10 would have been eaten. As a close air support aircraft, it's not unusual for the A-10 to operate from airfields close to the front lines, which oftentimes means makeshift forward air bases, where availability of maintenance crew and equipment is limited. For this reason, the airplane was designed to be easy to service and maintain in order to keep it flying. That said, the A-10 does have an unusual look, and I mean beside the nose art. The A-10's nose landing gear, instead of being in the middle, is off to the side. See, that iconic brrrt sound generates such a powerful recoil that can cause the airplane to veer off target. Unless the gun could be positioned in a way that the force of the recoil was exactly aligned with the center line of the aircraft. This meant the gun had to be placed near the center, with the shooting barrel, which is this one, accurately aligned with the center line. So the nose gear was pushed to the side to make room for the gun center stage, similar to how the advancements in military technology since the 1970s are now pushing the A-10 Warthog off the stage. The A-10 is now obsolete, and for two reasons. First, to destroy ground targets, aircraft no longer need to strafe enemy positions with guns. There are simply better platforms to do this job. If the target is a tank, man-portable anti-tank systems like Javelin can easily take care of it. And the prevalence of precision-guided munitions means that you could hit a target from much higher altitudes and with far better accuracy. And of course, there are a variety of unmanned aerial systems that can be weaponized to do the job. But the second reason is even more damning. The A-10's armor may have been sufficient to protect it against anti-air guns of the 1970s, but the same cannot be said today, where manpads can easily drop a slow and low-flying airplane out of the sky. Add to that modern and sophisticated surface-to-air missiles that could even target faster airplanes flying at much higher altitudes, and the A-10 simply has no chance. Don't get me wrong, I got nothing against the A-10. It's just that anything has a shelf life, and the US Air Force recognizes this, which is why it plans to retire the A-10 fleet for good by 2030, if not earlier. In fact, some of the A-10s have already been shipped to the boneyard, where they will be stored for parts, possibly used in experimental projects, and ultimately sold for scrap. As for the A-10's replacement, it seems to be the F-35. Two squadrons of F-35As are projected to replace the A-10s at Moody Air Force Base in Georgia in fiscal year 2027. That said, other bases, like the Gowan Field Air National Guard Base in Idaho, will be getting F-16s. What I don't know is when we're gonna see another aircraft with such a menacing look. That's Indiana Air National Guard's A-10, which was painted with a two-tone black and gray color scheme. And of course, a snakehead nose art. Because there is nothing more epic than quenching the thirst of a gun-wielding black snake as she wreaks havoc from the sky. Play Conflict of Nations absolutely free. This online PvP game lets you choose your own strategy to engage in epic battles and take over the world. Click the link in the description to get 13,000 gold and 1 month of premium subscription. This offer is only available for 30 days, so don't miss out.